Hey, this is Prak with iRepairMD. Today we have a drone that's been in a recent crash. And as you can see right here, there's been some issue with the gimbal. The gimbal shaft, the yaw arm has bent, and well, if you look at the yaw arm, you can see it's bent and it cannot hold steady. It doesn't stabilize. There's an issue with the whole camera, and you get this constant shake. So if you're trying to take any decent video with your drone, you're not gonna achieve it. So what we need to do is replace the yaw arm. So this is Prak with iRepairMD, and today we will be replacing a yaw arm with a bent yaw arm with a new one. For my website, list the links below. All right, so for this repair, you'll need a regular Phillips screw and a T6 hex screw. What we need to do is go ahead and take the battery out of the unit. Okay, so let's go ahead and eject the memory card that you have in here out. If you notice here, you're gonna get these hex screw or the T6 screw in a few locations. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the other two located here. What we need to do is go ahead and just take out the T6 screws. Okay. Just put this in a safe place. I like to use this torque screwdriver because it has enough torque and yet it's small enough for me to handle. It has a light at the tip of it. You can actually purchase that from my site too for about $100. And this has a wireless charging. It's a charging plate right here. It's really convenient. Just enough torque, but not enough to destroy the device. Okay. All right, this is the last two screw. Now, once we have that, what we need to do is go ahead and take the plate off. Okay, once you get this, the plate comes off fairly easy. What we need to do is just go ahead, lift the edges right here. There's a clip on here. So what you do, slowly lift it off, clip up. Okay, comes off like this. Now, what you dealt with are these two pieces right here. So now we're gonna switch over to the regular Phillips screwdriver. And free this. This is magnetic, so it pulls off really easy. Go ahead and take the plate out. Okay. Okay, so now we have a ribbon flex cable and a ribbon cable. Let's go ahead and take the ribbon cable off Let's press the notch here. This flex cable here has a connector. You just lift it up and free the connector. Now this drone's out of play. Put this away. Now all you have are the gimbals. And what we're gonna be doing is replacing this bat shaft with a new one. And this is the new Yaw Arm that you can get from my website. The link is below. And what we need to do is to be able to separate the cable here now, okay? All right, so what we have now is a gimbal. So what we're gonna need to do is actually start taking the brackets off. So let's go ahead and we need to separate the three-axis gimbal from the main board. So let's go ahead and remove some of these brackets. All right, so this is the plate. This plate is to protect the flex cable. Let's get that done. Let's go ahead and free the flex cable plate right here. What we need to do is take these screws out to access the connectors in the bottom. So go ahead and remove the Phillips screw from the light here. Take the Phillips screw out. Okay, once the Phillips screw is out, these are the clear plastic reset button. Let's go ahead and also remove that. Top and bottom. Okay, carefully remove this out of play. And now what you're gonna have is, this is actually connected through a pin connector. So it pressed right in, kind of like a cartridge. So what you do is you just pull it out. And that's the connector right there, you see? This goes into here. This is the other end of the flex. All right, we're gonna release the two connectors that connects the gimbal to the main logic board. Okay, removing that. Go ahead and pull it out. Like that. Okay, so now what we're gonna need to do now is just go ahead and take the bracket, the dampener brackets. These are the brackets, and the dampeners are these black rubbery piece right there. So now the dampeners are actually within the gimbal itself. These are the vibration dampeners. On the Phantom 3 and the Phantom 2, they were on the outside, and those are the things that you replace a lot when you crash yours. But this one, it's a black rubber dampener attached to the bracket. Alright, so let's go and take that out. Okay, now we have a free floating dampener here. Okay. So it comes right off fairly easy. But now what we need to do is actually take these off, okay? These need to be out of the way. So let's go ahead and let's take the other fasteners off. This is to secure the gimbal flex. Let's take those securing clips off. All you need is a Phillips screwdriver and a wow stick like what I have here. You can buy the wow stick from my website with the link below. Okay, so now you have this. So what you need to do is free this board up. Let's go ahead and free the board by releasing it. Now you have this board out of play. So now what you need to take out are these plates here. And that should allow the gimbal to freely come off, and we can put the main logic board away for future repair when we put it back together. All right, so now I got one more screw left. Okay. Now that we've got the dampener bracket off, like that, this should be able to just to slide right off. Just guide it through. Okay. So now let's put that out of play. So what we have now is the three-axis gimbal. You got the pitch, the roll and the pitch right here. The yaw arm. What is bent is this yaw arm right here. So we're going to replace it with this new one. Let's go ahead and we're going to take it out carefully. As you can see here, there's a adhesive right here that goes down. Okay, what we need to do is free this out. Okay, so what we have now, once we get it out, what we need to do is need to replace this unit here. All right, so what we need to do is go ahead and first thing we do is remove this plate right here, and there are two screws underneath. There's two Phillips. My wild stick won't be able to go in, so I'm using one of these traditional smaller repair screwdriver, the Phillips, to undo it. So go ahead and loosen this out. Okay. Now, once it comes off, let's go ahead and take it off. Okay, the plate here. So now, grab this off. So what we need to do now is go ahead and we need to free the flex cable here. And we need to remove the bracket. So let's go ahead and just take this piece off here on top. It's another Phillips screw right here. Let's put it away. Alright, once we have that done, go ahead and remove this. Is again, we'll need the T6 to remove the back panel off of this. Alright, so let me get my T6. Use the T6 here. T6 screw. Four T6 screws holding the plate, the yaw plate on. Yaw arm plate. You can access the pitch motor and the roll motor right here. Let's go ahead and access, this is the roll motor. Alright, so now we're going to free up this cable here, and that's what the roll motor looks like. Let's go ahead and just release the lock on it, free it up. Okay, so now let's go ahead and free this half off here. Now go ahead and free the actual motor engagement. So there are three flex cable connector that needs to be taken off. Alright. Okay, so now, once we have that done, let's go ahead and free the camera bracket, the cable bracket on top. There's another piece of plastic right here, a metal bracket that is securing the Yaw Arm on. Just gonna lift that bracket off. Okay, so now we have access to the mode, the roll, the pitch of the Yaw Arm now. Let's go ahead and safely free the adhesive off. If we pull it, you don't want to rip it. This is a good flex cable. So we slowly remove it. Okay. A little bit more left. Carefully pull it. There you go. It's coming off. Nothing's ripped. So let's go ahead and take the motor off. Okay. We're going to put it right back on after we finish this. Okay. Slowly pull it off. Now we're going to put the new one in. Like so. Now let's go ahead and replace it with the new one. All right, now we have to do the repair in reverse. Now we're putting everything back together. Once that is in, we can go ahead and transfer the components. There are two components here. We're going to go ahead and take this off of this one, of the old one. Let's go ahead and take the yaw motor off. This is the side-to-side motor. Let's go ahead and remove that from this yaw arm. Back into here. Okay. So let's carefully put this back into place. This time I want to use a regular Phillips screw. Drop it into place. A little tricky with the gimbal already assembled. Alright, so now you can see the yaw right here. What we need to do is actually put it into place, line it up right here. You have to maneuver our way around. This is very difficult. I'm sure you can do it. All right. The other two is fairly easy once you get this going. This is probably the hardest part right here. The top screw and the last two are fairly easy. So just run it right through. Okay, and then just screw it in. Okay, one more left right here. through, screw right in. All right. So now what you're gonna do is go ahead and replace the regular board back in. All right. So the backboard, you can see, rests right here. Let's go ahead and put the motor control board in. Slide it back into here. Where the white tab is. I'm gonna use my tweezer for this one. It's gonna get a little more difficult. These are all fine, small pieces. It requires a lot of practice to get back together. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and secure this back into the back. You guys see right here. I'm gonna fasten it back in. Make sure the white disappears. And lock it. All right. So now I'm gonna put the yaw motor control on. Make sure the white tab disappear. And then we're gonna send. This is the roll control connector. So let's go ahead and connect that in. And again, we're gonna push until the white meets the edge right there. Now lock it in place. Now all you have to do is go ahead and rest the board back into the slot. There are four tabs here. Go ahead and replace the plate. Then you can go ahead and put the torque screw back in, these long torque screws. Okay. Now that's in, let's go ahead and put the cover back onto here. Flex Gimbal cover. Okay. Alright, let's lock it in about right here. Make sure it's nice and rested. Done with the whole gimbal. The yaw arm part. Now I'm going to replace the adhesive back where it was. So we're going to put it against the wall, gimbal right like so, and then remember this bracket right here. We're going to go ahead and fasten it, so you can see the two holes right here. Let's go ahead and secure it into place. Now we're going to put that back in. These are the tiny screws on top that we have. Let's go ahead and replace those. The new ones. Okay. Let's go ahead and put the other screws back on top here. Yaw arm replace. Now we're gonna go ahead and run it back to the board. All right, so this is the fun part. Now what we need to do is, don't forget about this base right here. Okay, so have the cap on just like this. Now you go ahead and drop the screw in to here. Okay. And then go ahead and tighten it. And then the other piece right here. Go ahead and tighten that also. Screw that is. Okay. There you go. This screw, make sure it's all nice and secure. So now the cap is on. Took a little detour, but we finally got it done. And now let's go ahead and run all this back into the port. So what we want, see these, the T-bar right here. We're gonna run the cable through it. Okay. Once you have that nice and secure, the gasket goes right here. Okay. The gasket's in place. What we need to do is go ahead and secure the dampener bracket. All right, so now we've got the dampener bracket in place. Let's go ahead and screw one down, hold it down. Okay. Now, once you have that done, what you need to do is adjust the dampeners, make sure it matches. Okay. Now the dampener is secure. One screw is held down right there. We can actually go in and readjust the rest of the screw here to match. Okay, it's a little difficult in this thing, but there you go. Once all the holes are secure, go ahead and tighten it in. Let's go ahead and put the rest of the screws into place. Okay, let's one takes 4 screws. All right, that will keep it locked with the dampener, screwed onto the dampener, and the dampener will be attached to the body of the lower end of this, on the main bracket of the gimbal, the outside shell. All right. Okay, so once the screw is nice and secure into place, what we're gonna do is go ahead and put the, I believe it's the accelerometer or one of the sensor back on. Okay, like so. Let's go ahead, sensor board. Now we want to lay the sensor board right over here where it shows where the other screws are showing. And with that, we're gonna go ahead and lay the flex cable down. And these brackets, we're gonna align into place. Okay, now we're gonna screw them down. All right, once we get that screwed down, screw down and secure. Once it's screwed down and secure, let's go ahead and fasten down on the dampener brackets. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and screw down the fastener bracket left and right. Each side has 2 screws. Now you do the top half right here. I'm gonna lock it into place. There's a little tab right here. Now it's nice and secure. Let's go ahead and put the dampener bracket back on. Okay. Like that. Okay, so now let's go ahead and get to the flex cable. Let's go ahead and secure the flex cable back in. Put each of these back into place. Make sure the white is matching, and then press down to lock. Down to lock. With that done, let's go ahead and put the connector back on the main board. Now it's snapped down. Let's go ahead with these brackets, the metal bracket we had here. We can go ahead and secure it like so, like this. Let's go ahead and secure the tab. A little bit so you can slide, make sure this tab is in place. So I'm freeing up the hole right here, and has the other hole for the tab. Okay. Now it's locked down. Okay. So what you have now are the reset clear bracket, which goes about right here. Put that into place. Nice and secure. Another piece. Also secure. Okay, so now the gimbal is completely rebuilt. What we're gonna do next is go ahead and just install it back onto the camera. Oops, what we need to do also is make sure you add the screws here. 2 Phillips here to lock down like it. So get the two Phillips on top here. Okay, my battery's running low. This matter, even if you're very low, you can just torque it yourself. Torque it. Alright. Now let's go ahead and install this back onto the drone. Okay. So now we have the drone. And we have the gimbal. Let's go ahead and snap this connector back in. Let me snap it just right. Alright, so now the connector is on securely. And now let's go ahead and put the ribbon cable in to the other slot. Okay, and that's it. Now we're gonna go ahead and just put this place back in. Oh, by the way, I'm gonna show you guys something. Right here is a micro SD card, and that is the actual hard drive of the drone. So when you're doing a firmware update, this is where the firmware is being stored, okay? You don't remove it. This is what makes this thing possible. It's all the brain of it. This is the sonar, the audio height altimeter, and this is the pattern recognition camera. Two fronts are the obstacle avoidance. Okay, let's go ahead and put this into place. Snap it back in. There's a little bracket on the corners. Okay, so you just have to lock it in on this side. It's a little plastic notch right there. Okay, but before I did that, actually, okay, so now that we have that, it's all done right, this secure right here, let's go ahead and put the bracket back in. Bracket back into place. Okay. Bracket in place here. And by the way, this is the sonar audio for height, and this is the pattern recognition camera. This micro SD card that's actually secured into the main logic board here is the main operating system of the firmware. When you update it, it stores here. So what you don't want to do is replace that at all. You just update it. Okay, so now everything is back in. Let's go ahead and fasten the gimbal back on. So you want to do, there's a few tabs here. You want to make sure everything is resting and setting flush all corners. There you go. So now go ahead and secure this one too. All right, everything's in place. Now we're going to go ahead and replace all the screws. Put the torque back in. Turn the light back on. Okay. So the torque, the battery's running. My wow stick is running out of battery. I haven't charged it in almost a month, so cool thing about this is even if it's out of battery, you can still use it as a screwdriver. Like it's meant to be. You still have the LED light, so it'll illuminate areas that I need. And this is just enough leverage for me to put the torque back in. And there are 6 torque screws. There are 4 on the top and 2 on each side. There's some power left on here. There's still some juice here. I'll hand torque it all the way. Now back on this side here. Torque screw in here. Myself. There you go. Other side, 2 more left. Okay. It's always the final 2 screws that I have a hard time with. There you go. Take one on this side. And a lot of torque. Okay, so now that's done, let's go ahead and test this out, tap the battery in, power up the drone, on the controller, okay, get a better angle, and you can see now, the camera is no longer shaking, the gimbal is perfect, right there. And so what we're going to do is actually show you the feed. Go ahead and put the lens back on. Okay. So in order, it's really fine tuned. So even the slightest off balance of this will cause this to have error. So the lens is compensated, or is actually part of the whole balancing of this gimbal. So now that everything here is nice and set up, the lens is back on. Go ahead and power on the gimbal, power on the drone. Okay, let's take a look at it, see how well balanced it is. So now that's the front, you can see everything is all perfect. And let's go ahead and actually tap into the controller and see what the gimbal sees. Okay, let's go ahead. I'm gonna run the app on my DJI app, and this is what the drone sees right here. Let me control the pitch. Perfect. And then, all right, so I'm moving the drone back and forth, and you see everything is stable, no error. I'm inside, so it's safe for flying inside. All right, now let's go ahead and I'll show you something else that we probably need to do. You look here, power off the drone. What I recommend to my customer, and he actually requested, is that to prevent this accident from happening again, and if it does happen, minimize the damage, I recommend the gimbal guard, which I have here. And once you buy it from my store, which is the link below, all you have to do is to install it, just simply take out the T6 Torx screw on top. Two screws here. Okay. This is extremely light. It weighs less than 2 grams. And once you put it on, it protects the flex gimbal, and in the event of it does crash and hit all the way to the ground, it prevents the shaft of the arm from bending. It's made from lightweight PLA. This is corn-based plastic. It's biodegradable. And to install it, what you need to do is just, where the flex cable is, slide this on. And then the bottom, just raise it on top. Now you align the two holes up like so. And then, let's put this back in again. Again, to install it, slide it in. And now you need to secure with the screw to the T6 into place to lock it in place. Putting the T6 back on. And now you can see you have a little gap in the bottom right there. And what that does is actually, if it does hit the ground, this gap will actually dissipate the force and send it sideways, preventing this from ripping, bending. And also this flap right here protects the your gimbal, the flex cable, should it run into a branch and you get nicks. It's really expensive if it does get nicks. And there's no, once you transport it, there's no need to take it out. It actually will fit your current camera bracket. So you can see it works perfect with the gimbal. When you do need to store it, all you have to do is basically put the camera bracket back on. See, it does not interact or get in the way. The bracket, it's installed once and forget it. But anyways, this is Prak with iRepairMD. Safe repair and safe flying.